wasn't uncommon back in that day for people to walk back in large groups with their friends and family. So Jesus and his mother and father, they set off in a very large group to walk back home. But Jesus happened to not be in that group. And so Jesus' mother and father begin looking for him, and they just assumed maybe he's back in, but with the rear end of the crowd, with maybe friends or family. Maybe he's just walking back there. Jesus is 12 years old. So they just keep going. And then they realize, actually, they can't find Jesus. Like, he's not in the crowd. They realize he's not in the back. And so they already were a journey away. So they walk back, and 3 days they spent looking for Jesus. Like, I'm not a parent, but I imagine for parents in this room, if you lose your child for 3 days, there's probably some stress and anxiousness involved with that that I can't even imagine. But 3 days, Mary and Joseph, the parents of Jesus, are searching for him. And then they get back to Jerusalem, and they find 12-year-old Jesus in the temple, and he's listening and asking questions to the religious figures of the temple. And everyone was amazed at this young boy, of the things he was saying and his understanding of the scriptures. And this is what Mary, the mother of Jesus, says to him when they find him at the temple. So here's what it is. Luke 2:48. This is where the scripture picks up. It says, this is Mary speaking. She says, "Look, your father and I have sought you anxiously." This is what Mary says to 12-year-old boy Jesus. "Your father and I have sought you anxiously." And Jesus says, "I was doing my father's business, like no need to worry." But this verse stuck out to me as I was reading this passage. "Your father and I have sought you anxiously," meaning they were looking for Jesus wholeheartedly. Like, Mary and Joseph were looking for Jesus like their lives depended on it. They weren't going to stop looking for Jesus until they found him. They weren't going to let anything distract them until they found their son, Jesus. And I believe very clearly, very strongly, I believe this is a model for you and I. This is an example for you and I of how we are to pursue Jesus in our lives. And the honest reality is, Jesus is no longer walking the earth. He's not around. He's in heaven, seated on the throne, but he will come back one day. But regardless, we are to seek his presence wholeheartedly. We're not seeking the actual person, but we can seek his presence. Like, think about that. You and I are to pursue the presence of God wholeheartedly, anxiously, with everything we have in us, not getting distracted to the right or to the left, but to pursue God. And here's what the Bible says, that if we search for God, if we seek him with all of our hearts, we will find him. That's a promise we have in Scripture. And here's the honest reality is, many of, and this is speaking from experience, many of my anxiousness, my anxieties, my stresses, my doubts, my insecurities, my challenges have come from an absence of God's presence in my life. It's come from an absence of me not pursuing God wholeheartedly, and my focus, my mentality is askew because my heart is not fixed on pursuing Jesus. And right now, we're living in the midst of a global pandemic, and I want to be careful with how I word this, but I really strongly believe we're living in a spiritual pandemic right now, where there's so many people who aren't pursuing the presence of God, who their lives aren't marked by God's presence, and God's presence on our lives makes all the difference, because his presence brings joy and peace and strength and comfort, and God gives a peace that the world cannot give. And so you and I must make it a priority to anxiously search the presence of God. And he's allowed us to do that through scriptures. We can open his word and know God has revealed himself, searching the presence of God through the scriptures in prayer. We can do that. But I want to ask you, are you pursuing God like Mary was pursuing Jesus? Are you pursuing him this morning wholeheartedly? I heard a quote that said, "A heart not pursuing God is a heart not in love with God." And that may sound harsh, but it's very true. A heart not pursuing God is a heart not in love with God. And that's honestly very convicting to me. Are you pursuing God wholeheartedly? Where are you with that today? Is that the most important thing to you right now? Or have you gotten distracted? I want to encourage you and challenge everyone in this room, search for Jesus anxiously. Pursue him wholeheartedly, and you will find him.